And from here, I bring you a story from the past, from the light past, from the past which fills us like a crown on our heads, from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about a woman who was married in his time and had committed adultery with a man, and she came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said to him, Ya Rasulullah, I am a woman who has committed zina, and I am married, muhsana, and I am now pregnant from zina, Ya Rasulullah, fatahirni, bring purity to me, as Allah has ordained in capital punishment in the Quran. Subhanallah, strange is the matter of this woman. She acknowledges and knows that the punishment for a person, male or female, who commits zina when they are married, is none other than to be stoned to death until they die. She knows this, and she came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when she could have avoided it and asked Allah to forgive her. But because of the intensity of the sin which had reached her and the harm which had approached her heart, she came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said to him, Ya Rasulullah, purify me from a bad sin which I have done, a boundary of Allah which I have penetrated. How am I going to meet Allah? And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he turned his face away from her. And so she returned back to him and said, and then he returned his face away from her a second time until the fourth time. Why? Maybe she is drunk. Maybe she has gone mad. Maybe he was trying to give her the opportunity to return back and ask Allah to forgive her, that Allah will forgive her in another way. This is not the only resort. However, she insisted. And when she insisted, the Prophet ﷺ said to her, return until you give birth to the child. What is the sin, brothers and sisters, of the child? Where one of us, they go and go. When our women today, they go out and get abortions and kill this innocent child, you have no right to do this, brother and sister. You have no right just to do this, O husbands of your wives. They are a life which Allah has ordained to be born. And so the Prophet ﷺ said to her, go back until you give birth to the child. So she went, and after 9 whole months, she returned back to the Prophet ﷺ. Of course, he was thinking that maybe she will forget. But she returned back to the Prophet ﷺ with more intensity than she was before. And she said to him, reminding him, Ya Rasulullah, I am the woman who came to you pregnant because of zina and asked you to prove purify me with the capital punishment of Allah. But then you returned me to tell me give birth to the child. And here I am, I have been given birth to this infant. Tahirni Ya Rasulullah, purify me from this bad sin. And then the Prophet ﷺ said to her, return back until he has become independent of your breast. Until he's independent. Who is going to look after him after you? So she returned back, and this is the mercy of Islam towards the children. She returned back, وَبَعْدَ حَوْلَيْنِ كَامِلَيْنِ After 2 whole years of breastfeeding him, she returned back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she said, Ya Rasulullah, I am the woman who came to you who was pregnant of zina. You returned me until I came back when I had given birth to him. Then you returned me back until he has become independent of my breast. And she came to with her child, with a piece of bread in his hand. With a piece of bread in his hand to prove to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he has surely become independent of her breast. Why? It is so that she can prove so that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will not return her back. And after he made one of the companions or a group of the companions to look after or take custody of the child, they brought her. فَشُدَّتْ عَلَيْهَا ثِيَابُهَا رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهَا They tied her clothes on her. And then she was stoned. Until when one of the men threw a stone so hard that he made the blood seep onto his clothing and spatter onto his clothing. It was as he was so happy, as though he had done something so good. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam noticed this in his face and wanted to discipline the man and discipline the people. So he stood up in anger and he screamed in front of the people and said, وَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ تَابَتْ هَذِهِ الْمَرْأَةُ تَوْبَةً لَوْ تَابَ أَهْلُ الْمَدِينَةِ لَوَسِعَتْهُمْ تَوْبَتُهَا Wallahi, this woman has done such a repentance so valuable, that if you were to compare to the repentance of all the people of the Medina, then her repentance would have overcome them all. If you were to place them on a scale, then her repentance alone would have being far more heavier than all of the people of the Medina. If all of them were to drink alcohol and commit zina, then this woman's repentance alone would have overweighed them. And the Prophet ﷺ then prayed Salat al-Janazah upon her and asked Allah to forgive her. And she was raised, as he said, sinless the same way her mother gave birth to them.